everyone. It's Katie from A Printed Life, and I'm here to do an update on One Book July. So we just finished week three and are in week four. Although I know some of us started earlier and might have finished our whole month. I did start One Book July in my Creme Black Beauty Standard Tan. I think it was June 20th or 21st. I can't remember what date I had started that. And One Book July is, it's a time to figure out what works and what doesn't work for you, however you go about doing that. Obviously, this year had a digital component. Each year has a little bit of a different component. I had said at the beginning I wasn't going to do any digital planning, and I ended up doing just the tiniest bit. I would use my notes app and my reminders app to trigger reminders for things that I might think of when I was in bed or in the car somewhere. Obviously not driving. I'm usually the passenger. I don't drive a whole lot. And that ended up actually working well. I don't know why I didn't really use those things before, but I think I'll continue on that. Sorry about the extra noise in the background. Not a whole lot I can do about that if I want to film in the daylight. Anyhow, so my One Book July setup, I was using as a time to reset. I had kind of become overwhelmed with stickers and washi and color coding and changing out inserts all the time. So I did a total reset, even down to just a black ink pen, and did a Bujo style weekly layout inserts and collections. And I definitely enjoyed it. It was a good reset for me. Yeah, and I had a finance insert and a family collections insert, if you remember. And I also had my personal journal insert. And I had made these tip-ins for future planning. Well, it turned out I didn't really love this by the time last week rolled around. If you remember, I was in a planner funk and I said I was using my extra time pursuing artistic practices instead. And so I just kind of thought about my planner setup and what it was I was liking and not liking about it. And I came to the realization that when I make an insert, whether it be handwritten or on the computer for like my Etsy shop or something, I get sick of it. Even if it's just a Bujo type list, I get sick of it much sooner than I would a store-bought calendar insert. I don't know why that is. I feel like not too many shop owners would admit to that or even feel that way. You spend a lot of time working on something. I spent a lot of time on these tip-ins here. And in the end, I just didn't like them. After I did it, I haven't wanted to use them at all. So I don't know what that's about. I feel bad about it. It's not a part of myself that I necessarily like, but there you have it. So I am abandoning this for now at least, and I'm going back to my Hobonichi Weeks. I had been using this for meal planning and grocery list making. And so plan my meals out here on the left-hand side and my grocery list over here. Obviously, I haven't done it yet for this week, although I did do my grocery list over here, my last big one for that I did over the weekend. And I just was really enjoying this earlier in the year for my grocery lists. You can see it lays flat perfectly, unlike most of your TN inserts. So this fits really well in that front section of the shopping cart. You can just cross off what you need or what you've, you know, put in your cart already. And I was really liking that. And then obviously too, you have, you know, year at a glance, current year, next year, and year behind. And you've got your month at a glance. So you can, you know, mark down any appointments if you're out and about, special dates, that kind of thing. This obviously is very nice and compact, streamlined, fits well in my my slim crossbody bag, as well as, you know, diaper bag, whatever. It even fits in here in this pencil case really well. So I'm going to go back to this for that purpose, as, you know, my daily on-the-go planner, meal planner, grocery list. Just works really well for that. And for my journaling, I have been wanting to move into, you know, an authentic traveler's notebook. I like the simplicity of them, and it just so happened that I had an opportunity to go to a traveler's notebook meetup this past weekend, and a friend who knew I was interested in traveler's notebooks brought a new, you know, unboxed, it was still fresh in the box, special edition, or are they special edition or limited edition? One of the olive traveler's notebooks. And I just was really surprised. I was looking at like a blue or a black one, especially since the olive was a special edition and is now a little bit harder to find and costs a little bit more. And she was really kind and sold it to me for a very friendly price. And that's just wonderful. It's brand new in the box. So I've moved my personal journaling insert into here. And this is just the same one that was in my creme that I started the month out in. And I'm just gonna finish this up. I don't have too much left in it. So that's that. And then this is just the MD paper one that comes with it. And I'll move into there when I'm done with my Moleskine one that I had cut down. And I'd also printed out some college rule and a tiny grid, and started making some inserts earlier today to put in here. Obviously not going to have five inserts in there. But I just wanted some more journaling inserts ready to go. And I just printed this on Strathmore writing paper, I believe 24-pound, 25% cotton. It's nice paper. It takes fountain pen really well. It takes a light watercolor wash really well. So I need to bind these yet and trim them down. I haven't decided what I'm going to use for a cover. I don't think I'm going to do, you know, your normal cardstock like I would normally do, and I don't think I'm going to staple them. We'll see. I will definitely keep you posted on these and let you know how these turn out when I'm done with them. So this is going to be my journal, just nice and simple, slim, portable, love it. And I'm sure you recognize this guy, Hobonichi Cousin, A5 size. I don't have a fancy cover for this. I just have a cheap vinyl cover, and I think that's actually even what this is called. Just a cheap, like, $2 cover. And I do have an A5 Lahit. This is a bag in a bag, so it fits an A5 notebook really well, perfectly. And I've just kind of been stowing it away in there. I had started off using this, not really knowing what I wanted to do with it at the beginning of the year. So I have a lot of blank pages. So I'm going to be using this as my home planner. I like the month layout. I like that it's all grid. I like that I can see anything, you know, coming up out of the ordinary in here and do some future planning. So that'll be good for school appointments and doctor's appointments, parties, that kind of thing. And I did end up moving into here last week after I had put my last video up, and I went back the last couple of days on here and put in some past planning, and then worked on my future planning, and just kind of did very, very basic color coding with mild liners, and this worked out really, really well. I hadn't used this weekly spread like this yet this year, and I really liked it. I felt compelled to decorate a little bit, not go overboard, and just keep it really minimal, and it was fun. I liked it. So I've kind of got a little bit going for this week. Obviously, we're already on Tuesday. I haven't done much in here. It's summer, and yeah, I've got little ones that still are on strict nap schedules, so this is kind of my life. Anyhow, I like that I can jump ahead. When school's back in session, I'll have my, you know, hourlies if I want. Anyhow, I'm glad that I have this, and I've been using the daily pages kind of a little space for just a real brief overview, not my in-depth personal journaling, just a real brief overview of something from the day, and a little bit of doodling. So, and I think I will use whatever blank pages I've got. I think I'll go back and do some maybe lettering practice. I think that would be a really good use for these pages. So that's what I'm going to be doing going forward. And I told you for One Book July, I was just using this Pentel Energel 0.5. And I was really liking that. I'm glad I did do that, because I had kind of gone overboard with my color coding system. And I realized, you know, I was using all of these Uniball Signos on a daily basis for different things. I realized I don't need to do that. Just these basic 5 mild liners do the trick for color coding. Not everything or every person, every category of possible thing that happens in the day needs its own color. So that was something else I learned for One Book July. And I'm going back to my fountain pens for journaling. Yeah, that's it. So, One Book July for me is over. It has served its purpose. I felt like I learned a lot about myself and my planning and journaling wants and needs. And I do have a good takeaway to not force myself into something just because I made it. So I'm happy with that. And I might still even go back into this bullet journaling insert. I'm certainly not going to throw it away. I liked the collections I had started, and I'm going to keep up with those for the summer. And other than that, I'm just really excited about these three things. My Hobonichi cousin for my home planner, and a little bit of memory keeping. Hobonichi weeks for my purse planner and meal planner, grocery list maker, and my traveler's notebook for journaling. It's simple, and I am excited about this. I'm excited about this setup going forward. So I will keep you posted on how this goes. Please, like and subscribe if you like this video. Please comment. How is your One Book July going? Are you still going strong? Are you gonna persevere with your setup? Are you done? What did you learn? How do you feel about it? I wanna know everything. So anyhow, thanks so much for tuning in, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.